Interview is not to be thought as a question answer session. It is not a question answer session. So it is not like a rapid fire round that they lift questions and you give answers. It is a very purposeful plus formal communication. It is a very purposeful and formal conversation. You are having a conversation with the wise people in the board. Five people are there in the board, and these are the wisest people in UPSC, and you are having a meaningful, a very formal, a purposeful conversation. So definitely in this conversation, you have to do certain things, you should not do certain things, which we will come after some time. So to bring out what you have inside, there may be possibility of they employing some psychological test even without the presence of psychologist. Some of our students, when they went to interview, for example, Deepta, who is serving as Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax, when she went to the interview, they knew from the bio data that she is an electronics and communication engineer, and they gave a piece of paper, a blank paper, and they told Deepta to draw the hybrid curve. Hybrid curve is no way connected to civil services. So the hybrid curve, if drawn properly by Deepta, will not secure her IAS, because that is not a criteria to test the suitability of Deepta in civils to civil services. So it means what they are testing is whether you are, when thrown a challenge, whether you are able to take up the challenge. Your readiness is what is tested. If you hesitate, from the face of you, they will come to know that you are not confident. And you hesitate, they are giving the paper and you are, you know, moving away. If they give the paper, you have to bend towards them to take the paper. That readiness is what is tested. Sometimes, right? Sometimes, though it is not there in the original structure of the interview, sometimes they may also give you a photo, an image, and they can ask you, what is that thing which you are inferring from the image? This normally happens in the defense services personality test. There is a test called as thematic apperception test. They'll give an image and they'll ask some questions. You have to see the image and you have to give the answer for the questions. Thematic apperception test. This test, what they are doing is they will administer to you an ambiguous stimulus. Since the message is not very clear, necessarily you have to take a subjective interpretation of the stimulus. And when you try to take the subjective interpretation of the stimulus, naturally what will happen? It will extract from you what is within you. So though they may not give a test like this, there is an ink blot test. They'll give some ink blots and they'll ask you that, do you see anything from this ink blot? This is not happening actually, but in a similar fashion, instead of showing an image or showing the ink blots, they may ask a question which necessarily triggers your subjective understanding or your subjective state of mind. Simply they'll ask a question. that there is a scam present. They don't give you a proper clue also. There is a scam present, a very, very big scam in India today, and all newspapers have written about that scam. What do you think about that scam? The question is very ambiguous. They are not telling you what scam, because there are many scams. What scam I should speak about? So naturally you speak about a scam which is making rounds now in the news. The Rafael. Right? So they come to know your state of mind, that you are having in your inner mind that this is the scam. And you don't think about the other scams. So which means that you are only thinking about a scam which is politically making rounds. You don't think about a scam in some states in social sector initiatives. You don't think about a scam which is present in some places in Panchayat Raj institution, National Food Security Act implementation. So are you preoccupied with a particular thing in your mind? Your preoccupation with the politically overloaded scams. So from this, they will come to know that this is what is occupying your mind mostly.